floor. Mathematics and meditation, these are the two extreme opposites in life. Between these two opposites, life spans. Why do I want today to draw your attention to mathematics and meditation, which both, I guess, are fields which are quite far from most of you? So the first reason is because since I was 17, I devoted my professional life to mathematics, first as a student, then as a university professor, as a teacher, but also as the head of a technology center, which is called the Software Park Hagenberg. And at the same time, since I was 17, I became very much interested in meditation, and since I was 31, I'm regularly meditating. So I just want to share most part of my life with you today. And the second reason is because if we understand mathematics and meditation and the span in between, then we can understand current world and current life, which for some people look very complicated. But in fact, it is simple. In order to understand mathematics and meditation, we just have to understand these three arrows, and in fact, a fourth one. And the fourth one bends back, comes from the three arrows and bends back. So what do these arrows mean? They explain how we deal with life, with reality. For example, here you see a platform, oil platform, drilling platform, and we want to control the valves at the pipes, 50 valves, 50 pipes, in an optimal way, so that finally we want to optimize the flow of crude oil. And what we have to do is to observe many things about this platform, the pressure and the construction and the length and many different things. Observation, observation, not only by our senses, but of course today by devices for measuring. And then we have to think how to solve this problem of optimal flow. And this basically is a mathematical problem. I promise you not to shock you today with any formula. But in principle, it is what we call a non-linear system of equations. And if you know how to solve this, then you can find the optimal position of the valves that makes it possible to control the flow of crude oil in an optimal way. So by thinking, we find out how we should act before we even touch any of the valves. So observing, thinking, acting, these are the three arrows. And in an oversimplified way, we could say that the cultivated, over the centuries, cultivated way of observing, this is called science. And the cultivation of thinking over the centuries, this is called mathematics. And the cultivation of acting is called technology. So it's science, mathematics, technology. And now you can do some exercises about the millions and millions of situations you encounter in real life, but also in more technical life. For example, if you go to a supermarket and you see two boxes of apples, and one is, say, 1.5 euros, for 2 kilos, and the other is 2.5 euros for 3 kilos, you observe this. But then you start thinking a little bit. I hope you found out which choice is better. And when you did this little calculation, little mathematics, then you choose the cheaper one. And there are millions of other situations, and then you will see, observing, thinking, acting. These are the three arrows, it's like a wheel. And these situations can be arbitrarily complex. For example, you can observe, so forget about the platform, you can observe in a computer a person who has raw files, and then he encodes the file, the files with some encoding encryption system like Kekka, for example. And you see the non-encrypted files, the encrypted files, thousands of such pairs, and then you could find out the password only by thinking. And interestingly enough, the method that is behind finding out passwords in such a way is again solving nonlinear systems of equations. Now, these are the three arrows. What is the fourth arrow? The fourth arrow, we call it reflection, self-application, self-reference. And what it means is the following, that all this development of science, mathematics, and technology over the past centuries was not only used in order to make our life more successful, the material life more successful, more goal-oriented, and solving problems from real world, but all the results of this cycle, observing, thinking, and acting, was also used in order to improve our technology of observing, thinking, and acting. So we also could say, invention was used in order to improve our technology of inventing. So it is bending back. This is self-reference, it's self-application. And self-application is not something artificial, it is basically the intelligence of nature and the nature of intelligence. It is how evolution happens. Now this is great, it's all great, and we all experience the big success and benefits of this observation, thinking, acting cycle and its self-reflection. Our lives become, in some way, from the material point of view, more and more easy, more speedy, more effective. And of course, all this is great, and we all can enjoy this, but there's also a downside to this, and this is, maybe many of you experience this, that this hectic run of this wheel of observing, thinking, acting, it's getting faster and faster. We have the feeling it's getting so fast that for some of us it's too fast. And people have the feeling that they are not driving this wheel, but they get more and more driven by this wheel. And first-class citizens of our technological age are in danger to becoming first-class patients in first-class hospitals for burnout and all these diseases of modern life. So the question for all of us today, more than in any other age, must also be, how can we stay the masters of this wheel? And how can we prevent to become slaves of this wheel? And the answer is meditation. So what is meditation? Now again, this is very simple actually to explain. And I don't do it by words. Just look to the next few slides. Okay. So meditation gives you the possibility to experience silence. And actually, I should have stopped here it's very difficult to stop at the right moment, because actually the silence you experience in meditation is not the nothing. It's not not observing, not thinking, not action. It's not the nothing. It's not boredom. It is just the moment before the yellow arrows disappear and only the self-reflection arrow stays. What can the self-reflection arrow experience? It can only experience itself. So in this moment, when silence happens, consciousness experiences itself. And this is the state of meditation. This is the state which we can call silence. We can call it in many different ways. Every word is wrong. So the experience cannot be replaced by speaking about the experience. The experience of experiencing silence in meditation is a very blissful one. It is not an intellectual one. It's not a mathematical one. It is a very blissful human experience, and it can give you the freedom, the feeling, to be the master and not the slave. It can give you the experience of the freedom that if you go back to outer life, you can have every option to choose, every possibility to put your attention on whatsoever, on oil platforms or on apples or on coding or whatsoever, and be successful with your mathematics. So mathematics is here for making you successful in outer life, in real life. Meditation is here for making you happy. So, of course, the question is, how can we improve our mathematics, our ability to do mathematics? And how can we improve our ability to experience silence? And of course, already a little improvement in both the intellectual capability of doing thinking, and on the other hand, improving a little bit our ability to experience silence will have very beneficial and drastic impacts on your life. And so the question is, how can you improve your mathematics, your thinking, and how can you improve your ability of meditating, meaning going into the direction of silence? Now, for the first question, one possibility is, if you live in my area, just write me an email and I will invite you to some of my seminars, which I call explanation training, meaning I will teach you a little bit of mathematics, how to improve our thinking ability without mentioning any formula. Okay? And the other question is, how can you start practice meditating? There are many possibilities today. It's a pluralistic society which we can enjoy. There are so many possibilities. Unfortunately, in all my hectic life as a mathematician, I did not find the time for becoming a meditation teacher. But as Confucius says, whose temple I just visited a couple of weeks ago, was very fulfilling. He has one important message, and he says, life starts only with 70. So maybe in the rest of life, I will find the possibility to become a meditation teacher, and hopefully I can help society more than by my mathematics. But in the meantime, if you are interested, also write me and I will give you the address of a couple of very good meditation teachers whom I trust. So finally, what does all this have to do with the topic of this TEDxLinz workshop, whose title is Reconnect? Now, mathematics, meaning the center of this scientific, technological, economic spiral. Mathematics gives you the possibility to connect in a very efficient way to what? To the whole of the universe. We reach further and further in our scientific discoveries. It gives you the possibilities to connect to deeper and deeper levels of nature until the very finest layers in quantum physics, etc., etc. It gives you the possibility to connect with all the world in global society through the internet. You won't believe, but in the basis of the internet, this is mathematics. Okay, so mathematics gives you the possibility to connect more intensively and more intensively. And meditation gives you the possibility to disconnect like a switch in a moment. You are the master. You need not stay in the wheel. But the actual experience of meditation is much deeper. It is not disconnection. It connects you with all. So mathematics is the arts of connecting you with everything. Meditation is the arts of connecting you with all. So in this sense, it is reconnecting. So, and this is the reason why I thought that maybe it makes sense if I tell you a little bit today about mathematics and meditation, which span life in a certain sense. And span means enjoy everything in between, enjoy your thinking, enjoy your experience of silence, and enjoy everything in between. And here's a little question for you. If you look to this slide, I wanted to explain what it means to experience silence. And also it explains what is mathematics, because mathematics is now just a thing which is not here. Please look to this slide and think about why this slide is incorrect. Yes, it's incorrect. There's a copyright on it. There is no copyright for thinking and no copyright for experiences silence. It's your property. Thank you.